Hello, welcome to this video. Let's get a general overview on the most important features inside Microsoft SharePoint Online 2019 and see how to start with these for the first time. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and our official website to get free tips, tutorials, giveaways, and extra content. Microsoft SharePoint is an online platform spread among small and large companies. It creates a common online intranet page collecting news, documents, resources, and lists to edit and share between people and groups within your organization or external. It allows to have deep control on sensitive information and communication, advanced file versioning, and knowledge sharing through blogs and notebooks. SharePoint is accessible online with your web browser from both Windows and Mac platforms, and available in three main versions. SharePoint Online is the most common solution for smaller businesses, hosting intranet sites on Microsoft servers. SharePoint Server is the most complete version, with intranet addresses completely customizable and pages hosted on local private servers. SharePoint App is a free version, which allows to access all SharePoint sites directly from smartphones. In this simple tutorial, we are going to see how to use SharePoint Online as the main administrator. You can obtain this version with any SharePoint plan or with any Office 365 subscription. To access your SharePoint site, just enter inside the main Office website and log in. Then, just go to the SharePoint Online app to enter inside your main intranet page. This is hosted on a Microsoft server with your organization name as part of the address and SharePoint.com as domain, unless you have bought a custom one. The main page is divided in two parts. On the left, you have the Quick Sites list, including the starred ones you are following and the most recent ones you have visited. On the right, you have a big preview on the most recent news posted on your SharePoint sites, and at the bottom, all the sites you have visited often. You can also use the search bar in the top left corner to look for any interested site or page. Before creating any site, let's understand the basic structure of any SharePoint intranet. This intranet is made by several independent sites, collecting pages, news, documents, and anything you need to share inside your organization. These sites can also include subsites showing other content with dedicated options. In addition, you have two main kinds of sites, the communication sites and the team sites. The communication sites have a modern visual layout used to communicate and share news and events on a large audience. The team sites can be either public or private and are used to share information and make collaborations on projects between all the users approved on a defined Office 365 group chosen for such team site. By default, your intranet includes just a single communication site, which is your homepage, with the main web address of your intranet. To create a new site, go to Create Site above and choose the kind of site to use. Let's start with a new communication site, defining site name, address, description, and default language. On the left, choose the kind of template to use for the site design. In this video, we will see the default topic. The new communication site opens with a nice layout showing links to pages, news posts, organization events, and shared documents. In the top right corner, you can enable Following to add this site to your most favorite list and use Share Site to invite and give access to people, office groups, or even everyone inside your organization. If you go to Settings and then to Site Permissions, you can check the privacy and accessibility options applied to the current site. By default, only you have access to the site, being one of the site owners that have full control on the site content and layout. You also have site members that can view, edit, and moderate the site content and site visitors, which can just read and download content from your site. You can go to Advanced Permissions Settings and then to Permission Levels to manage all the possible actions that owners, members, and visitors can perform on the current site. You can also create custom office groups by going to Create Group above. You can go to Settings and then to Site Information to rename, delete the site, or change its basic logo. You can go to View All Site Settings to adjust all the possible options for your current site. Whereas to edit the site template and appearance, you can go to Settings and then to Change the Look to adjust the basic color theme, header, and navigation structure. To check and manage the content of your site, go to Settings and then to Site Contents. This collects all the site media, pages, and documents grouped into several kinds of SharePoint apps, such as document libraries, events lists, and page libraries. The document libraries list all the media files and documents inside the site, such as all the files used for site logos and backgrounds on site assets, or all the documents created and uploaded by users inside documents. Inside a document library, you can use New to create a new folder, link, or a new file you can edit with Office Online. You can also upload any file from your computer by either using Upload or dragging and dropping these files directly inside the library. Use Sync to sync this SharePoint library with your OneDrive account. In this way, you can download these documents and edit these offline in your computer and then resync these on SharePoint once you come back online. When selecting any file, you can use Share or Copy Link to share it, Download to download it, Delete to remove it, and Open to open and edit the document directly on SharePoint. You can also go to Version History to check all the past versions of the document in a chronological order to view or restore. When getting a lot of files, you can use Add Column to show more metadata or the search bar to find documents matching your keywords. By default, you also have the Events List app. This is the official calendar shared on your site showing meetings and appointments to all the people inside your organization. Inside your site, you can also include new apps by going to New and then to App. You can add other document libraries, custom lists, and other special apps by visiting the SharePoint store. The communication site also includes a section dedicated to all news and links you want to share, complete with title, description, and thumbnail. To create a news post, just go to Add and then to News Post. This creates a new page inside your communication site that will be collected under the News section. On top, type a title, upload a background picture, and add content by creating web parts with the plus button at the bottom. These are parts of the news page showing different kinds of content, from picture, videos, and text, to interactive content, chat, and pieces of HTML codes. For example, you can use text to type text content, document library to link any of your media libraries, News to link your news pages, and Hero to include an interactive web part, which directs your visitors to intranet sites, pages, or files with a great thumbnail and call to action text. You can use the tools inside the black box to edit, move, or delete the current web part or just click on Page Details to correct and adjust more of its options on the extreme right side. In addition, you can adjust the page layout by using the Page Sections. These group several web parts together in order to move, arrange, and adjust their placement inside the page as you like. You can create a new section by using the plus button on the extreme left and use its tools to move, delete it, and the edit section to adjust its layout and its basic background color. This color fits the main theme color you have chosen for the main communication site this page belongs to. Once the new page is ready, just go to Post News on the right to publish it. Also, the main communication site follows the same structure of the news page, including several sections collecting web parts you can edit with the tools on the extreme left. The site also includes the navigation on top, including quick links to intranet and internet pages you can customize by going to Edit. The main site and all its news pages are collected inside the Site Pages library in .aspx format. You can create other new pages by going to Site Page above. This new page belongs to the main communication site, and it works just like the news pages, with the difference that this page won't be listed as a news post. Pages and news posts do share the same privacy and permission settings of the communication site. You can come back to the main SharePoint page by going to SharePoint in the top left corner. The team site is another kind of site that allows to get major control on privacy and permissions on the site content. This is recommended for private groups working together that need to share sensitive projects and documents. When creating a team site, you automatically create a group email address or Office 365 group associated to it that grants access to your new team site content. At the bottom, you can also set the privacy settings. Choose Public to make your team site accessible by anyone inside your organization, or Private to make it reachable just by users invited and approved as members by the team site owners. Team sites can be edited and shared just like communication sites. They also have the same settings panel to adjust permissions, reach its content, and change its look. They also include the navigation on the left and the several sections containing web parts, more focused on team groups rather than external communication. Team sites can include site pages, but also wiki pages and web part pages. Wiki pages are simple text pages very useful to share ideas, comments, and knowledge across the team site group. Whereas web part pages are empty pages you build by adding web parts from scratch. The SharePoint intranet can also include site collections such as subsites, referring to a main communication or team site more focused on a particular theme. Subsites can either inherit or get their own privacy settings and office groups independent from the main site. To create a new subsite, go to Site Contents and then to New Subsite. Define name, description, address, privacy options, and also the layout template to start from. All subsites are listed under Subsites inside Site Contents. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to check our YouTube channel and our free Microsoft Office guide to learn more and completely for free.